look at this ranking task with the carts moving along a horizontal surface and talk about acceleration and talk about tension. Now we're going to use the hyperphysics page to help us with this, but let's first look at what's going on. The one thing that's constant is the hanging mass on all these, and what is changing is the mass of the cart up top and the initial velocity. So first off, it's not real obvious. I was trying to give a hint, but the initial velocity really doesn't matter. It's going to be slowing down. Initial velocity is 30. Because there's a weight down here, it's going to decelerate. So all of these are going to be decelerating due to this second mass down here. And quick thought would be, well, since all this hanging mass is the same, the deceleration will be the same. But what is changing is the mass. So let's take a look at this page on hyperphysics. So it's a mirror image is all. And we can look at the expressions that they've developed. Free body diagrams are always good to look at. So in terms of mass one, we got weight down, normal up, and the tension created by this second hanging mass. The free body diagram for this hanging mass is weight down and tension up. Tension's constant for both of them, and the acceleration will be constant for the both of them. So as we derived in class, the acceleration of the system is equal to the hanging mass, this is the net force, pulling it down, or for the top mass, pulling it to the right, divided by the mass total. That's going to be the key thing for us to look at throughout this. So first off, since if you look at acceleration, back to our ranking task, the acceleration is going to be inversely proportional to the mass. And since the hanging mass doesn't change, all our answer is right there. So the bigger the mass up top, the lower the acceleration. Or you could think of it as the one with the smallest mass. So 20 grams is the lightest, will have the highest acceleration, D and F. And then the next one would be, I guess, 40, and then 80 and 90. But what about tension? Let's take a look at tension. The tension of this system will be, if we look at it in terms of the equation up here, it's equal to m1 times acceleration. And so it gets a little bit tricky because acceleration does depend upon both masses, but it's also going to be dependent upon what is the mass being accelerated. The tension is the same throughout here, so don't get that confused. In fact, I'm going to highlight something. Note that the tension T is not equal to the hanging weight. Okay. In fact, this is what I love about this site is you can just kind of play with some numbers. So I'm going to make these two masses equal, and notice that the tension is 122. Okay. Now, I'm going to double the mass of this top one. We talked about if the mass increases, we should see acceleration decrease. Well, let's watch that. And sure enough, it did go down. Acceleration did decrease, but tension increased. Let's double check it. Let me bump this one up to 100 now. Watch what happens to acceleration. It jumped up again. So back to our problem here. As the mass increases, and so what is it, 80 or 90, that's the biggest one, then the tension, this will have the highest tension, and the smallest tension will be D. You can fill in the rest.